six, a helping hand with your land.
Neil from Messex here today to have a conversation with you about hydraulic flow on a compact tractor. A couple weeks ago, we did a video showing running a hydraulic auger on the front of a small machine. A lot of you commented down below about the speed that that auger ran and why can't the manufacturers just give us more flow? So today, we're going to talk about some of the engineering reasons behind that. Now let's be clear, I am not an engineer and a tractor product designer, so I might get some of the minutiae wrong here, but I have a fairly good understanding of some of the trade-offs that are made when these companies go through and build equipment. When I say trade-offs, that's important to remember because when you go through and you look at building a tractor and designing a piece of equipment, a lot of what the engineers do is go through and make trade-offs between different operating characteristics. Did a video a while ago on some of the trade-offs that are made on a loader. A lot of guys focus on say the lift capacity of the loader, but that can very easily be manipulated by doing things like lowering lift heights and changing geometries. You can come up with a loader that can lift a ton, but may not be very usable. And so that's something that you want to avoid. And we kind of tread into that same kind of stuff when we start talking about hydraulic flow. That flow is not free. There's a little bit of math here behind the effort that it takes a piece of equipment to actually pump fluid. There is a static constant that it takes 1 horsepower to move 1 gallon per minute of fluid at 1500 PSI. Now, most of our tractors run at somewhere just under half of that. If you go through and actually like work out what that works out to move 10 gallons per minute at 2400 PSI through your tractor takes 14 horsepower in and of itself only to move that fluid. Now, I'm sitting here on a Kubota L3301. This tractor is 33 engine horsepower, 26 PTO horsepower. If you expected this tractor to move 10 gallons a minute of hydraulic fluid, which it does, between the power steering pump and the implement pump, this thing moves 10 gallons per minute, you're left with 8 horsepower in order to drive the tractor around. It takes 14 horsepower in order to pump all that hydraulic fluid. So simply going and raising the amount of fluid that those pumps are moving can leave you with nothing left, no engine horsepower left, in order to operate that tractor and drive the thing around. Now these are gear pumps, they're running all the time and they're not necessarily consuming all of that horsepower constantly. However, there is a parasitic loss to simply be spinning that pump and moving some of that fluid. And some of that is reflected in your PTO horsepower. You'll notice if you go through and look at bigger ag tractors, as you go up, when you're starting to move more of that fluid, you lose a little bit more of that horsepower going out to the PTO. And so PTO horsepower is a measure of the loss of everything that's happening inside of that tractor. The transmission has a lot to do with that, but the hydraulic pumps do as well. The only place where you can kind of get a free lunch when it comes to this is when we get into real heavy ag tractors. When you start to move into things like closed center load sensing hydraulic systems, that type of hydraulic system doesn't use a gear pump in order to move the oil. So in machines like skid steers and compact tractors, small equipment, you have gear pumps that are basically always running as that engine is running. When we move up to the really large machines, now we can have a hydraulic system that operates a lot like a hydrostatic transmission where you have a variable swash plate in there that changes the amount of fluid that pump is moving. That kind of tractor, when you're moving, say, 40, 50, 60 gallons a minute of hydraulic fluid, is actually able to destroke those hydraulic pumps so they're not constantly sitting there and draining on the engine. But those are hydraulic systems that cost thousands and thousands of dollars, way outside of the scope of a small machine like this. So, might be a little bit interesting for you to think through. I would love to see some high horsepower, small tool carrier type tractors that give us an option for the guys who want that hydraulic horsepower, but by no means would it be smart for a tractor manufacturer to go through and throw a huge amount of hydraulic horsepower at a tractor and simply sacrifice the rest of the operational characteristics of that machine. So, if you're going through the buying process for a piece of equipment, you have service needs or parts needs that we can help for machines that you've already got, give us a call at Messex. We're available at 800-222-3373 or online at messex.com.